I'll be back.
Of Eli Whitney Technical High School, as we honor our seniors on this special occasion, we ask that you be respectful of all the participants taking part in the ceremony by allowing all of our family and friends to hear the speeches and graduates' names being called. Please refrain from using any artificial noisemakers or anything that will disrupt the ceremony. Finally, we ask that you adhere to the stadium guidelines and the CDC safety guidelines. Thank you. I would like to introduce the acting principal, Mr. Joseph DiNatale.
Thank you, Mr. Ricco. Good evening. I am acting principal DiNatale, and I would like to welcome you, parents, guardians, family, friends, and honored guests, to the graduation ceremony for the Eli Whitney Technical High School, class of 2022. Thank you all for coming. Now it's my distinct pleasure to introduce the Eli Whitney Technical High School, class of 2022, led by valedictorian Kamaya Dingo, salutatorian Madison Carney, and class president Wendy Caban. Will the audience please stand? Thank you very much. Please remain standing. Wendy Caban, President of Class of 2022 and all invited guests, please be seated. Thank you. At this time, I would like to introduce our invited guests, the members on the dais. Please stand to be recognized when called. From the Connecticut Technical Education and Career System Central Office Administration, Interim Superintendent of CTEX, Dr. Helen Solick. Educational Consultant, Pat Chaldivio. Supervisor of Literacy and Humanities, Dr. Darcy Piano. Supervisor of Pupil Services and Special Education, Ms. Tanya LaPlante. Supervisor of Professional Development, Ms. Tanya Stout. Assistant Principal, Mr. Tim Bienz. From Eli Whitney Technical High School, Senior Class Assistant Principal, Ms. Renata Santel. Assistant Principal, Ms. Natalie Willis. Class advisor, Ms. Erin Marico. Yeah! Senior class counselor, Mr. Chris Lasour. Yeah! Director of school counseling and admissions, Ms. Jeannie Lewinsky. Yeah! And Mr. Pavarotti himself, Mr. Valdez. Yeah! Also joining us on stage are our keynote speaker, Dr. Regina Hopkins. Class valedictorian, Kamaya Dingle. Class salutatorian, Madison Carney. Senior class president, Wendy Caban. And lastly, the Eli Whitney faculty in attendance. Please rise and be acknowledged. At this time, I would like to introduce the salutatorian, Madison Carney.
Good evening. I would like to begin with congratulating the class of 2022. Today is the first step into transitioning into adulthood. I'm extremely proud as we all persevered through a pandemic to be here today. The pandemic left many of us in confusion and burden as it turned our lives around in a 180. The first few months were a complete nightmare, full of fear and utter chaos. COVID was a learning experience for all of us. It taught many of us to be more grateful and appreciative of the things that were taken for granted. It also taught us how to be responsible and independent enough to work with teachers and complete assignments from a distance. Although our 4 years were ideal, I'm glad that I got to experience these hardships with my senior class. While we may not have hung out all the time or conversed together often, we still shared a huge stepping stone in our lives. The experience of the graduating class of 2022 will always be something that I cherish and hold dear to my heart, as I hope you guys will too. Even without COVID, these past 4 years at Eli have been hectic. Still, I applaud the teachers and faculty for the strength and tolerance they held throughout these years. Many of us wouldn't be here today without their encouragement and support. I would like to thank Mr. Dean Natale for listening to students and trying to meet us halfway. He also gave us privileges and freedom to participate in more activities and interact with each other like the basketball training. I would like to thank Mrs. Marico, our senior advisor, for supporting us and making sure we have the opportunity to have traditional senior experiences. I would also like to thank our guidance counselor, Mrs. Lester, who is always there to help us. He provided constant checkups and meetings to help with college, basketball, and dealing with problems non-academic related. I know that Mr. Lester helped me greatly with all the problems these past few years, and I am extremely grateful for him. I would even like to thank the rest of the teachers for constantly being there with me. We have all grown from the naive middle schoolers we were when we first came into bright young adults with plans for the future. It's amazing how fast these last 4 years have flown by. It seems like yesterday, everybody was scurrying around trying to find their homework and classes, complaining about not wanting to do Alex, going to gym, or their double periods. Well, look at us now. We made it. We're all sitting here because we deserve it. We worked hard, and today is our day to celebrate. High school isn't easy, no matter how much people say it is. It's a time in your life that can shape your future significantly, as well as the time you begin to find yourself. High school is a big milestone in your life, and with this being a trade school, it has given many of us the opportunity to figure out our dreams and future careers. We have all worked hard to get here, and our work didn't go to waste. A high school diploma is a huge accomplishment and will help open doors of opportunity for us in the future. Let today not be an endpoint, but launch you into the direction you see. Whether that be going to college or getting a job, make sure the choices you make best suit you and that you're doing what you love. This is your life, and it's up to you to go out and seize the day. I'm grateful that I got the opportunity to know all of you and wish you a life full of prosperity, success, and happiness. Thank you.
Thank you, Madison. Now I'd like to introduce the class valedictorian, Kamaya Dingo.
Good evening, everyone, family, friends, faculty, and more importantly, our Eli graduates. I would like to start off by asking the class of 2022 to display our gratitude. Thank you to our teachers and families for supporting us through our 4 years of hardship. But of course, we can't forget to reflect on our own contributions in reaching this point. Our graduation is a coming of age. As we walk across the stage, ending our high school chapter, we walk into a new one, the unknown. Malcolm X once said, "The future belongs to those who prepare for it today." And I believe that we as a class of Eli Whitney Technical High School have exemplified this very statement. Though many might object to this, we got to admit we did learn a lot. Nevertheless, our learning experiences extend beyond the mere basics in the classroom. Many of us learn how to finish and turn in assignments moments before it was due during class. We've managed to learn how to turn 3 minutes of passing time into 20 minutes. We've learned how to be the loudest class during the only two pep rallies we've had during our 4 years of attending Eli. But putting these jokes aside, we not only as students, but as people have learned priceless and valuable lessons that will carry us throughout our reading lives. Our high school chapter has ended, and a new chapter of our lives is waiting to begin. Although you can say that we didn't have the traditional high school experience, we can still admit that we had our fair share of fun moments at Eli. We persevered through the COVID pandemic. Remember how we've all shared the same thought that we would miss out on the traditional senior experiences as the last two classes before us had? Regardless, we still survived and came out of this experience empowered and stronger. We've overcome major academic challenges, such as finishing or coming close to finishing the agonizing, dreadful Alex math program. It's as bad as it sounds. But few graduating classes can say the same. The point is, we've learned something and shared similar experiences, whether you noticed or not. Whether that was going to classes or skipping them, we've had our fun and did it together as the class of 2022. But as I sat down with Madison as we talked about our speeches, it gave me a chance to really look back on and think about what I've truly learned throughout my high school chapter. A common denominator resurfaced: doubt. Doubts that I've never truly learned anything and that these years were a waste. Doubts that I won't be successful. Doubts that college wouldn't be for me, or that I'd get into my career path to find out it isn't right for me. That'll be lost. And I'm sure many of you have experienced similar thoughts. So I wanted to relay this message for everyone. Doubt is ultimately one of the biggest setbacks, destroying more aspirations than the thoughts of failure. We can navigate through all of our setbacks or failures in different ways, but doubts will never. They can take away all your motivation and strength if you give in to it. We have the power to silence it. Don't let doubt define who you are and take a toll on your goals. Recover quickly from your setbacks. Believe in yourself and your abilities, coupled with motivation and effort, will help you achieve your goals. At the end of the day, it's up to you to create your own path and determine your life story. Developing innovation, self-discipline, and perseverance will make it great. Thank you.
Thank you, Kamaya. At this time, our senior class school counselor, Mr. Lasore, will announce the class of 2022 scholarship benefactors.
Thank you, Mr. Vitale. Good evening, friends and class of 2022. Staff, good evening. For colleges and universities, scholarships are financial awards designed to help students pay for their undergraduate degree. Scholarships can be awarded as a single installment or as renewable funding over the course of attending college. And they come from private sources or the institutions themselves, directly from the colleges. The class of 2022 has been offered hundreds of thousands of dollars in financial support, including from the following: Bowie State, Central Connecticut State University, Clark Atlanta, Dean College, Fairfield University, Georgia State, Johnson & Wales, Long Island University, Massachusetts College of Art and Design, Moore College of Art and Design, North Carolina A&T, Pear College of Art, Penn State University, Post University, Quinnipiac University, Savannah College of Art and Design, Southern Connecticut State University, Universities of Bridgeport, Hartford, Rhode Island, St. Joseph, UConn, UMass Boston, University of New Haven, Virginia State, Western Connecticut State University. There's a lot there. That's a nice job, class of 2022. Students have also received private scholarships from places like the Utility Contractors Association, Hamden Rotary Club, and the New Haven Scholarship Fund. Let's give them a round of applause for these accomplishments. At this time, our senior class assistant principal, Ms. Santel, will announce the outstanding accomplishments from the class of 2022. Well done.
Thank you, Mr. Lasore. Good evening, everyone. Throughout this ceremony, you will see some graduates with accents on their gowns, including cords and stoles. They all represent specific achievements deserving of recognition. Therefore, at this time, I would like to recognize all of these students. Will those students who have attained a top 10% ranking academically please stand and be recognized when I call your name? Kamaya Dingle. Madison Conley. Evan Blair. Antoine Acosta. Kiana Cruz. Garza, Heidi Chavaria, Dee Belize, Tiana Bailey, Alianis Perdomo, Jerry Ellis Ayala, Wendy Caban, and Mark. Officers, please stand and be recognized when I call your name. Wendy Caban, Senior Class President. Kiana Cruz, Vice President. Nazare Bradley, Secretary. Antovani Acosta, Treasurer. Congratulations, you may be seated. Will all students who have earned a stole for membership in the National Honor Society please stand and be recognized? Congratulations, you may be seated. Our students of the month are recognized for being kind, having exemplary attendance, maintaining good academic standing, possessing a positive attitude, working hard, being respectful, and are motivated and deserving. Will the senior winners of our Inspire Award please stand up when called? Michael Kane. And Tobani Acosta. Evan Clare. David Glazier. Giuseppina Sabano. Anya Brown. Garnett Myers. Madison Carney. And Kamaya Dingle. Congratulations, you may be seated. Will all of the hairdressing and cosmetology students who have passed their state exams please stand and be recognized? Congratulations, please be seated. Will all of our culinary arts students who have earned the Serve Safe Allergen Certificate this year please stand and be recognized? Congratulations, please be seated. Will all of our graphic technology students who have passed the Publishing Precision Exam please stand and be recognized? Congratulations, please be seated. Will all of our automotive technology students that pass the ASC exam please stand and be recognized? Congratulations, please be seated. Will all of our precision machine students that pass the NIMS certification please stand and be recognized? Congratulations, please be seated. Students who receive the HAAS online milling and lathe operator certification, could you please stand and be recognized? Congratulations, please be seated. Will our carpentry and electrical students that receive the Green Step certificate please stand and be recognized? Will the carpentry students who pass the precision exam please stand? Congratulations. Will our students that pass the NACTI exam please stand and be recognized? Will all of our students that pass the OSHA 10 exam and the CFR 1910 exam please stand and be recognized? Congratulations, please be seated. Will all of our plumbing students who completed the Connecticut Department of Labor Hours for Plumbing Apprenticeship please stand and be recognized? Congratulations, please be seated. We would like to recognize a senior with perfect attendance for the last 4 years. She has never missed one day. Josephina Tabano.
From Eli Whitney in the face of extreme adversity. This year's recipient of the Ray Canty Award is Alonja Humphrey. Dr. Regina Hopkins. Yeah. Dr. Regina Hopkins is an educational consultant in the Bureau of Educator Effectiveness for the Connecticut State Department of Education's Talent Office, where her work focuses on partnerships, strategies, and initiatives to create anti-racist, equity-driven district and school leaders, and a racially, ethnically, and linguistically diverse educator pipeline and workforce. She has been instrumental in the creation of a comprehensive plan to attract, recruit, support, and retain educators of color. Throughout her tenure at CSDE, Ms. Hopkins has championed inclusion and amplification of student voice, led efforts to critically examine mindsets and practices that preclude equitable access and opportunity for students, and for partnerships with families. She's challenged administrators, educators, and colleagues to consider how their beliefs and worldwide view hinder the creation or help and nurturing the public education system at spaces that reflect, include, and value diverse identities and contributions. She earned a Doctor of Education degree from UConn's NEAC School of Education. Her dissertation research examined the relationship between the racially neutral public school disciplinary policies, systemic racial disparities in student discipline outcomes, and the efficacy of restorative practice as an equitable and racially just discipline model. Dr. Hopkins also holds Juris Doctor from Yale Law School. Her legal career included advocacy and legal practice in the area of immigrants' rights, housing and homelessness, enforcement of Connecticut's Freedom of Information Act, enforcement of human rights and commission and opportunities, and educational equity. She has successfully argued 3 cases to the Connecticut Supreme Court. Dr. Hopkins is committed to the development of anti-racist systems, practices, and policies to amplify the full contributions and rich stories and perspectives of marginalized communities to support the thriving and liberation of all people. She's the chief steward for the P3A bargaining unit and an outspoken member of the State Employees Bargaining Agent Coalition, Racial Justice Committee. Please welcome Dr. Regina Hopkins.
Conviction of your worth and your value. because each of you is uniquely special. You have talents and gifts that this world needs. Don't let other people's biases, bigotry, self-righteousness, or unwillingness to acknowledge your humanity and your awesomeness to cause you to dim your light. Love yourself. Believe in yourself. Live authentically, live in your truth. Know that your ability, your skin color, your hair texture, your native language, your place of birth, your faith, your pronoun, your zip code does not make anyone better than you and you better than anyone else. During one of her last speeches from the White House, former First Lady Michelle Obama said this: "Our glorious diversity, our diversities of faith and colors and creeds, that is not a threat to who we are. It is what makes us who we are. So don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to be focused, to be determined, to be hopeful, to be empowered. Empower yourselves with a good education. Then get out there and use that education to build a country worthy of your boundless promise. Lead by example with hope, not fear. So graduates, I call upon you to be truth seekers and truth tellers. I challenge you to be active and engaged citizens who hold your representatives accountable. I implore you to register to vote and then cast your vote in local, state, and national elections. I encourage you to seek political office, not to enrich yourselves or exert control over others, but to be the conscience that America needs. To be vigilant, unapologetic defenders of true democracy. To make this country a safer, more equitable, just, livable, and humane space for everyone. I need you to get into what Georgia representative and lifelong social justice and activist John Lewis called good trouble. Your voice, your perspective, and lived experiences matter. Each of you can make a difference in your community and in this world. In 2016, Michigan resident Amariana Copain wrote a letter to then President Barack Obama expressing concern about the unsafe water in her community and the insufficient response to the problem. Mari, or Little Miss Flint, as she is now called, was 8 years old when she wrote that letter. Mari's letter prompted a visit to Flint by President Obama and became the catalyst for a heightened response to Flint's water contamination crisis. Mari's advocacy and activism for clean water and other social justice issues continued. This July, Mari will be 15 years old. So never doubt that the socially conscious actions of one fearless individual can make a positive difference in this world. 2020 graduates, I wish you all the very best.
Thank you, Dr. Hopkins. Before my formal remarks to the class of 2022, I'd be remiss if I did not provide an opportunity to recognize those individuals that have supported you in achieving this goal of high school graduation. Seniors, please stand and provide a shout out to your parents, guardians, and family members in the audience. Realization of goals attained, and acknowledgement of successes achieved. So it's only fitting that tonight we commemorate the travel. It's not the end of the road, but a new turn. We all experience new turns in the road of life. My recent turn brought me back to Eli Whitney's acting principle. We've all been on quite a journey. The class of 2022 entered Eli Whitney in 2018. As freshmen, you experienced it. Exploratory process, alternating cycles. Then in 2020, the COVID virus hit. It was an unexpected turn for all of us. We all worked together as community and family to safely move forward. Let's not forget Google Meets. Turn the camera on. I need to see you. Are you there? Once again, maintaining 6 feet apart, mask requirements, alternating days. As we turn back to normal times, with people and families gathering, sitting in restaurants, everyone back in school, we all felt better. As a community. It was a welcome sight to see someone's face. Now thankfully, we're all sitting together in an auditorium for the special event. Henry Ford wisely said, coming together is the beginning. Keeping together is progress, and working together is success. You experience challenges in the classroom and in shop. Our teachers are preparing you for college and career. You are able to experience production work and attend work-based learning. Many of you visited Sikorsky and learned about post-graduation opportunities. You also participate in Skills USA, winning many trophies. You were able to participate in sports with spectators. We had esports compete, make it to the finals, baseball play the state tournament. We had fun events, battle of the classes, senior prom, senior outing in Holiday Hills, a senior picnic the other day with DJ, dunk tank, and pizza truck, and pizza truck, and pizza truck. I kind of enjoyed that, I can't tell. And the pizza truck. Now we reach a point in the road where you exit from Eli Whitney. You take with you many experiences that help shape and prepare you for the future, whether in trade, college prom, military, or work. I ask of you, focus on your communication skills. Put the phone down. Do a few less TikToks. And Instagram posts. Call a friend or family member. The phones do work that way. Barack Obama said, it's important to make sure that we're talking with each other in a way that heals, not in a way that wounds. It's up to you to help change the world in a positive manner, as we have experienced many unfortunate events. Once again, you will experience many turns on a road of life. Some sharp turns, some straightaways. You've all worked hard to be sitting here in Lyman Hall. Your families are here and proud, and cannot wait to see the great things you will do. There's one thing in life that is constant, that is change. As a young man many, many years ago in high school, I enjoyed my shop classes, especially manufacturing. I credit my teacher, Mr. Fleming, for challenging me and introducing me to the manufacturing program at Central Connecticut State University. The choice to attend Central for manufacturing degree changed my life. I was able to transition ultimately into teaching and administration. If you ask my high school friends, where would I be? You may not have guessed the high school administrator. We're all here to celebrate your achievements and continue on a pathway of lifelong learning. May you always lead by example, work hard, and play straight. May your successes be many, and your tribulations be few and far between. Here's a quote from Michael Jordan. Some people want it to happen. Some wish it would happen. Others make it happen. We wish you the best life, has to offer, and it's my honor to be with you today. Make it happen. Congratulations, class of 2022. Distinguished guests, parents, faculty, and friends, as the Board of Education maintains a governing body responsible for establishing policy requisites and standards for graduation. Eli Whitney Technical High School's governance is granted under direct supervision of the State Board of Education. This evening, Dr. Ellen Solik, Interim Superintendent of CTECs, represents that board. Dr. Solik.
I'm going to go off the script just for a second, which is probably sending all of the people behind me into sheer panic, but I promise I'll only take 30 seconds. I need to share something with all of you from my heart. And I haven't had the opportunity to do this until tonight because this is the first time that all of us have been gathered together in one very special place. As you might remember, I arrived at the CTEC district, very honored to be the leader of this district back in October. And right after I got here, we had some issues at Eli Whitney Technical High School. We had issues that, as a collective family, a CTEC family, we had to get together in a hurry and fix. And lo and behold, a mere 4 months later, after I heard comments from the community such as, we're Eli Whitney and we're kind of a second fiddle high school. Or I heard comments like, we're Eli Whitney, we're not really all that special. I am here to tell you tonight as the superintendent of schools for the CTECs district that Eli Whitney Technical High School is the most improved technical high school. The leadership of Mr. Dean Attali and his team, the teachers, the staff members, and everyone who is a part of this very special family at CTECs, and most especially Eli Whitney, it is you who have reshaped, reformed, and renormed Eli Whitney Technical High School. Parents and community members, you have something and someone to be very, very proud of this evening. And I thank everyone here for what you did. And now, I have the official duty of going back on script. Through the superintendent's authority, I have duly examined the technical and academic records of this class and certify that they meet all requirements as set forth by the State Board of Education. Therefore, would you all please rise, class of 2022? Of 2022, which is now eligible to receive their high school diplomas.
Thank you, Dr. Solik. And now, the moment we've all been waiting for. We will have the trade department heads call the roll. Ms. Willis?
You want me to follow them? To follow them, yes.
Yeah.
Electrical instructor, Mr. Roger
Giori. Jonathan Arce.
Kiana Cruz. John Sanchez. Juan Takura. Rochelle Robinson. Jason Sanchez. Javen Velez.
Benjamin. Nashawn Brown. Madison Hardy. Kamaya Dingle. Zanaya Paredes. Christopher Asari. Samantha Pearson. Josefina Devon.
Thank you, Mr. Marichak.
Schumacher Banks. Jada Bell. Justin Brady. Patricia Donis. Barnett Myers. Dolores Parker. Domo. Jamie Proto. Dylan Ridgway. William Ridgway. Anthony Rosa. Jordan Short.
Thank you, Mr. Barry Amendi, Department Head, Precision Machining Department, and Lou Rucker, Instructor. Now we have Department Head from Hairdressing, Ms. Danielle Halliworth, and also Ms. Ashley Stevens. Emma Siniscali.
Jalen Gray. Kylia Harriet. Kiriana Manzo. Leda Perez. Keishla Rivas. Delizbeth Rodriguez.
Thank you, hairdressing. Health tech instructor, Ms. Sharon Johnson.
Genesis Harris.
Alejandro Ryan.
Yeah.
Michael Kane. Paul D'Agostino. Josiah Jackson. Devon Jarvis. Dante Mayone. Jamar Meeker. Naomi Pavone. Justin Short. Zion Shore. Oliver Stevens.
Thank you, Mr. Walsh. Mr. Edwin Armstrong, Culinary Department Head.
Anya Brown.
Excuse me, one second. I just want to make sure this is lined up still.
Jada Carr. Rebecca Jordan.
Hey now. Hey now. Hey now. How you doing? Hey, babe.
Dylan Mortimer.
Evan Libby. Samantha London Rand. Antonio McKnight. John Moffitt. Devin Oliver. Jaden Oliver. Brandon Perez. Kayla Nidia Rosa.
Brian. Naishka Gonzalez. Ayana Gormley. Janesha Matos. Mendez. Adamaris Mera. Janisha Mitchell.
Remarks for class of 2022. I wish to acknowledge those who have been supporter of this wonderful event. Superintendent Solit, for your support. Our assistant principals, Ms. Lewis, with the coordinator, Mr. Santel. We'd also like to thank Mr. Beans, who has been with this class. Our senior class counselor, Mr. Masur, Ms. Walensky, Mr. Valdez, the program creation, students, and Mr. Mark Chuck and Mr. Hodgkins. All the Whitney staff, thank you. To the class of 2022, on behalf of the entire faculty in the Eli Whitney Federal High School community, we wish you health, happiness, and success as you continue to achieve and grow. Please know that you all will be missed, but also know we'll be here if you need us in the future. And finally, congratulations to all of you as we move forward to take your place as leaders of our great nation. Class dismissed. Mr. McCarter, they're coming through there, folks. Excuse me, I would also like to recognize one student, Lieutenant Bailey, congratulations. I'm sure you'll have a great night. Thank you. Now we'll process back to the room to achieve, get your diplomas. If you can let the students please process out. Thank you.